Starkway is the company behind StarkX and Starknet. It's a scaling solution that utilizes zero-knowledge proofs for faster transactions and a very high throughput. In this video, I'll guide you on how to get started with using the Starknet via Argent and possibly get yourself eligible for an airdrop if there is one in the future. So let's get started. Before jumping in the video, a quick disclaimer that none of the content on this channel, including this video, is financial advice. Always do your own research before using or investing in any service or protocols. This video is only for education or entertainment purposes. If you like a deep dive into Starknet and StarkX, please let me know in the comments below. For the purpose of this video, I'll keep it short. Starkway is the parent company that currently has two products, Starknet and StarkX. StarkX is a scaling solution that is application specific and only a few dApps have been deployed on it. For example, DYDX, SoRed, Diversify, etc. The idea is similar to subnets on Avalanche, like the subnet that was rolled out recently for DeFi Kingdoms on AVAX. While Starknet is a ZK rollup layer 2 scaling solution, which will be integrated into ETH mainnet, and this will allow anyone to build on top of Starknet's ZK rollups. It is not EVM compatible, but they are building a tool which will allow developers to port their dApp from Starknet to EVM, as Starkware is using Cairo as a programming language as opposed to Solidity. But once they build the app will translate a Cairo to Solidity and vice versa. The only way to take part in the current Starknet Gorilla Testnet is via Argent desktop wallet. Please note that this is different to the Argent mobile wallet that is running on ZK Sync rollup. So if you haven't watched that tutorial on how to get set up and how to get started on that, that video will be in the top right corner. Now let's get into this tutorial. The first step is to download and configure Argent Starknet wallet. So if you just go to the Chrome store, you can download the wallet. Add extension. As always, all the links to all the articles and resources will be in the description, so you can use that to follow along on the tutorial. So as you can see, Argent X has been added to Chrome. So what you can do is to now open the extension, and it's your first time, so as you can see, it says disclaimer, this is an alpha product for developers. Future versions will likely include breaking changes, so that's fine. Click on I understand. You can restore a wallet if you used the older version that was running on Starknet. You can import that. But for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to create a new wallet and set a password and create wallet. All right, so it says download your backup. So make sure you keep this download safe. For example, on MetaMask, you have a seed phrase to restore or to reactivate your account, to import your account. So you'll need this file to import your wallet further down the road. So click on download and that file will be downloaded. Make sure you have a backup and make sure you know that. All right. So as you can see, it says pending transactions to deploy wallet. So tap on that. It will show you the, so it says unable to log your transactions, but it will create a wallet on the testnet. It's deploying, so give it a couple of minutes, it should be fine. And as you can see, it's automatically connected to the Gorilla testnet. So wait for this to complete. Once the pending transactions are gone through, we can move on to the next step. All right, so the deployment has been completed, so your wallet has been created on the testnet. So next step is to mint some tokens, as you know that we need some tokens to do some swaps and stuff like that. So click on mint and give it some time. It says network fee, and then click on sign, and it will now mint some tokens for you and give you some tokens for test. Now, as you can see, it's on Gorilla testnet, so you need some Gorilla or GETH to carry out transactions or pay for the gas fees. So you'll need to use a faucet to get some GETH. And now Starknet has their own faucet as well, so you can try that. So as you can see, I've received 1,000 tokens as test. And what I'm going to do now is I've opened up the faucet for Gorilla ETH from Starknet. So I'll use that. I'll copy the account address and I'll request for some GETH. Paste it. I'm a robot. And send request. As you can see, it's initiating. It will send you some GETH for transaction Gorilla ETH that will work on the Starknet Gorilla testnet. Waiting for confirmation, give it a couple of minutes. It might take a bit longer as well, but depending on the congestion and depending on how much funds they have, you should receive some GETH from the faucet. All right, so as you can see, it says request complete, and I've received 0.002 test ETH. Right, so close that. And now what you want to do is there are a few dApps that have been deployed on Starknet, Testnet. You can try those out, right? So there's nothing else you can do. There's nothing on the mainnet. The first one is MySwap. So it's just a basic AMM. There's option for pool charts and stuff like that, but not everything works. So it's connected to Starknet Gorilla at the moment. And click on connect wallet and connect your Argent wallet. Connect. And it's connected. So let's see what tokens do we have. For example, if I go to my wallet, as you can see, I've received that ETH and I've received some test tokens, right? Let's see if I can swap that test tokens. As you can see, it says balance 1000. So that's test token. Let me swap some for ETH, right? So let's say 50. Let's swap, sign the transaction through. So that's how you do a swap on MySwap. Let me just add that to my wallet as well, just in case. So as you can see, the transaction has been sent and it has been received. And you should see a confirmation once the swap actually goes through. As you can see, it says swapping. So there's a lot of congestion on the Starknet at the moment. So the transaction might be a bit slower. You can also go to the pools and you can add liquidity to different tokens if you like. The reason I suggest to use all of these test nets is because there's no proper procedure on how these applications or these dApps will give out tokens in the future. For example, Starknet will have a token, but no one really knows how they're going to distribute that. It doesn't look like there will be an ICO or stuff like that, because if they raise money, then it will be a security. So probably they will find a way to make sure that the early adopters get rewarded and look after the platform. So there might be a way if they will find a way to reward the people that try out the platform early on. So it's nice to try these platforms out that probably will have tokens in the future. So you can probably get benefited from the dApps that you use on Testnet and also from Starknet as well, because you contributed to that network testing phase, right? So while that's happening, I'll go and try the other dApps. The other one is Jedi Swap. So it's basically just an AMM on the Testnet, Starknet. Basically, just connect your wallet, Argent wallet again, and carry out some swaps. Another cool platform is Brick, where every block or every brick is considered as an NFT. So if you go to the app, you can actually build your own as well. And for the first time users, at the bottom, you say claim your 1000 bricks and start building. So click on that. Want to brick, that's fine. So it's minting bricks for you. Click on sign and you will receive 1000 bricks. All right, so what you do is basically you can choose a color and you can create blocks on top of them, stack them. And what you can do is you can mint on chain. So you can mint whatever you created and you can actually list it on mintsquare.io. So this is another platform, NFT platform. I think this is the only NFT platform on Starkware Testnet. So give it a go, create a brick and mint it on chain. And listed on Mint Square, so that you'll be doing a lot of transactions, and it probably would be helpful in the future. So that in this way, you're actually using a lot of protocols that are building at the moment on Starkware Testnet, and in the future, if there is incentive, you'll probably get it, right? So I'll probably have another video on how to mint an NFT on Starknet Testnet, but for the purpose of this video, this is only on how to set up and how to use or take part in the Testnet. If you have any other questions or if you run into any issues, as always, please reach out to me on Twitter at @OneLifeInvestment or in the comment section down below as well, as I try to reply to each one of you. And if you have anything else, any topic that you want me to cover in these times, please let me know in the comments as well or on Twitter, and keep on pushing out useful content for you guys. Thank you, and you have a nice day.